Hi everyone, I'm Alex Zaves and welcome to the Arts and Crafts Show. Okay, good show, bad show. Let's talk about what a good show looks like. Okay, good show is, you go to the show, it's a really good day, sunny outside, perfect weather, not too hot, not too cold, nice calm breeze, the customers come early, they start to buy from you. They don't ask for price. They like what you have. The customers are happy. They buy more than one. And you have a line of people ready to buy something. Okay. I mean, not like, you know, for 5 minutes a line. I mean, like a line for like an hour at a time. Always have somebody, two, three, four people online ready to buy something. You're feeling really great. It's like, everybody loves my work. Way, it's, I'm happy. And you look around, it's like, the whole show is full of customers. And all the people in the show are buying. And all the craftspeople are busy. And when you get a chance, you realize that you're not going to have enough work left over for Sunday. So what you do is you silently, you know, start making the prices 10, 15, 20% higher when you get a chance. You start putting it out in your booth. The customers still come. They don't question what you've done. Even at 20% higher your price, you're still selling more than one. They're happy. This has happened to me. This is really real. And I've even had been making prices 20% higher in front of them, putting it over here. They still don't question that. They're really out there ready to buy. They're spending cash. They're not giving you checks or credit cards. I mean, the money is just flowing. It's like a really good feeling, an upbeat atmosphere. And at the end of Saturday, you realize you don't really have much work left. Okay, Sunday's usually a little bit slower, which is fine, but you've probably sold two, three, four times what you thought you were going to sell. That's a really good show. Okay, Sunday comes, and it's not a bad day also, but, you know, not as many customers come that day, but they still all come and buy. And then you realize you've just about sold out. Even items that, you know, you have like 40 of, and usually you'll go all the way down to like 7 or 8 of them, and then they don't want to buy that either because there's not many left to choose from. They'll buy them all. Okay, and there's nothing left in that category of what you're making. It's like, if you don't have a picture of it, you're going to go, can I reproduce that again when I'm back in my workshop? It's all gone. This is all gone. I've sold everything. Even though, you know, because a lot of times, you know, something that's only one left, people don't want to buy. They, oh, there's something wrong with that. No, good show, all gone. All right. And you're traveling home. And, you know, when you get to the show, you're going to be setting up. Everything is so well packed in your van that it's muffled, it's quiet, it's full, you know? And when you're going home after a good weekend, a really good show, you hear in the back of your vehicle, it's like all this noise, clankety, clank, clink, 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 bang, bang, whatever, you know, it's like, that's really a good sound because you've sold everything and nothing, you know, it's all empty and things are bouncing around because there's so much space available because you've sold everything. And that's a really good feeling. And that's a good show. Great weather, great customers. You got better prices than you thought you were going to get. And it's almost all gone. Problem is, if you got a show the next weekend, how are you going to make up for it? Okay, then you begin. Okay, that's when the worry begins. Okay, I've got to have to work extra long this week to get ready for next weekend. And sometimes you'll have two great weekends in a row and people will go, I can't, you know, I don't have enough work or enough inventory for the other weekend. So really good shows. You feel like everything you're doing is right and you make a lot of money and your work is excellent because that's how your work gets better, is that you sell everything and you begin to work more and you get better at your craft or your art because the work is the teacher. And that's how, you know, it is for us. Bad show. Okay. I've done some bad shows, all right? But one that comes to mind is, you know, when we travel, sometimes you travel halfway across USA to do shows. We do a circuit around. We don't always know the town that we're going into. We just book for this weekend and the following weekend, the weekend after, and maybe miss a weekend, and we do that one. We're kind of traveling and doing shows. It's called the circuit, okay? Well, this one show I went into, it was a bad show. I'm going to tell you right up front. And I knew it when you could feel it when you're driving into town at 5 o'clock in the morning, it's just beginning sunrise, you can sort of see everything around, and you're driving through town and there's bars on all the windows. And I'm not talking about just in the porn shops, which this town had plenty of. I'm talking on all the other businesses as well. And then you start noticing there's a lot of thrift shops in this town. I mean, do people have money or they can only buy from thrift shops? Okay, maybe it's just in the beginning of this town. Then you get deeper into the town, nothing's changed. Bars on the windows. And then when you get into the center of town, there's a lot of these bars, you know, these where people go drinking and, you know, the sports bars and things like that. And that's where we were going to have the show. At 6 o'clock in the morning, we were going to be able to set up. Except this particular show, when we got there, and I joined the other artisans that are standing around at the show, we're looking at a sea of beer bottles, beer cans, cups. In some areas, you couldn't even see the street. It was so heavy with beer cans and things of that nature. I guess they just had a beer party night till 2, 3, or 4 o'clock in the morning. We're looking for the organizers because they hadn't even set up. You know how to mark our boots yet, because they were too busy trying to get one of the backhoes to push all this beer paraphernalia out of the way off to the side. So, you know, when you're limited in time to set up, you want to start setting up at 6 in the morning. Well, we couldn't do that. I think we got to start setting up after they marked out our spaces really quickly at 7 or 7:30 in the morning. You know, customers normally come to the show at 10. Well, not at this show, okay? And this was a tough show to do, you know. You're right in the middle of town, bars all over the place. And at that time, I was doing copper water fountains. So I could set up in within a few, 2 or 3 hours. But really, because you had to get your vehicle out of the area. So, you know, usually it was like 9 o'clock, but everything ran late. A lot of us didn't even get set up until 12 o'clock. All right, so bad show, all right? Customers came out, I guess hung over or whatever, on Saturday, and I was lucky to make one sale at that show. One copper water fountain, it was about $150, and it was a check. Okay, so which means, is that check gonna be any good? I mean, I took it on good faith, and like I do a lot of times, and I just hope it was good. And I'm going, this is not a good show. I didn't even make back my booth fee yet at that point, okay? And so, okay, so, you know, we all stand around because we have a lot of free time, not many customers on Saturday, which is supposed to be the best day. All right, so Sunday comes along. Well, it couldn't be much worse. I mean, I only made one sale on Saturday, so what could I say? So, but Sunday was a little bit better. Didn't do very good for that weekend. I forget, maybe $700 for the whole weekend, which basically I could probably say just above zero, you know, when you think about your expenses, your don't even forget about your time, okay? You're not even getting paid for the 20 hours for being in that show, just your time alone. Forget about that. Just talking about your basic expenses, your booth fee, your gas fees, you know, just food, whatever. Very difficult time. But it was an experience. It was probably one of my worst shows. I've done other shows that have been not so good, you know, but I mean, I didn't have to deal with all the crud on the floor and not being able to set up. I mean, I've had shows where customers just didn't show up and I didn't sell anything for the day, and that feels really bad. And it's just a one-day show and it's a local show, and I mean, bad shows. I mean, I did local shows, and it's only one day show, and it's every week. And I, I had like 5 weekends in a row. I didn't sell anything. And that's when I realized it's time for me to move. And I did. And I ended up traveling around the country doing different shows around the USA. Then I encountered this show, you know, the one with, you know, with all the craziness, you know, the all night parties and all that. Anyway, that's what we do. We enjoy the good shows and the bad shows. And I think we have to average it together. Over the course of how many years you do shows, in my case it's 40 years, so I average it all together, and I can say it's been a fun ride. I have no problems with it, and when you look back, you can kind of smile and kind of go, you know, you take the good with the bad, as you do with shows, the good weather and the bad weather. Sometimes you get rained out completely, thunderstorms all weekend long, or perfect weather. And where you do make the really good shows 2, 3, 4 times what you thought you were going to make. So average it together and you'll feel a lot better about what you're doing. Okay, so that's good shows, bad shows. If you could give me a thumbs up and ring that bell and you'll be ready for the next exciting arts and crafts show information that I have. Share it if you really do like it. And I will see you at the next arts and crafts show. Thanks very much. Bye.